spear is stronger now.
Oh.
The cult won't stand a chance.
Is it? Okay, I'll take your word for it. Upgrade the spear of Leonidas here at the forge of Hephaestos, using artifact fragments. Upgrading it increases your adrenaline and unlocks more powerful abilities. Collect artifact fragments from defeated members of the Cult of Cosmos. Review the quest menu to check progress. Yeah, okay. Spear level 2. Plus 6% health gain per adrenaline spent. Maximum adrenaline segment 5. Maximum ability rank 2. Okay, whatever that means. Sure. Alright, I guess we're done here. Time to head back out. And, tell Herodotus about all this.
It's clear someone was here far before we were.
Quiet. Now why is he, lurking about outside? Is he scared to come in? Or is it because...
Leonidas knows this place existed?
Because the door closed behind us? Oh, right, yeah. And it can only open by the spear. Oh. What the?
Time to talk.
What do you want to talk about? Wait, are we talking or are we running away? What's going on?
You're not hard to track.
Did you come alone? Are you all right? Alexios, you're alive.
Don't touch me.
Come on, little brother. You have to tell me everything. What's happened to you?
I don't have to tell you anything. I don't know you.
Well, I know you. It doesn't matter. There's more important things to argue about.
You're right. Like that stunt you pulled with the artifact. It got my attention, if that's what you wanted.
What? The artifact showed the truth. We're family. And we made it out of Sparta alive.
Yes, it did show the truth. It confirmed what I always knew. You threw me off a fucking mountain.
What? No. That was that crazy priest fella. The one that I threw.
If that's what you think, Alexios, you must have hit your head on the way down.
I've heard this story, and not from a liar like you. And never call me Alexios.
Right. Deimos. Now him... I don't know.
He's a demigod, worshipped and feared by the cult and all the Greek world.
I see.
Sounds like a fantasy to me. Did the cult cook that story up too?
I'd watch your fucking mouth, or I'll shut it for you.
You didn't when you had the chance before, and I bet you won't now. This is stupid. We need to find our mother.
I'm not interested in reunion. I just want to know what you think you're doing.
Same thing as your cult. Looking for Mirini, our mother.
They don't need her.
Your cultists think differently. She's their next target.
If they ever pursued her, it would be to kill her. But if you don't know where she is, that means she abandoned you too. How sad.
Even if we were abandoned, we survived. We can go back to the way things were if we can find her.
The cult has no interest in sentimentality or family. Its only aim is control.
If it's true they're after us, tell them they'll never find Nikolaos. He's off the map. Trust me, I've searched myself.
If I could find you, the other long-lost child of Nikolaos, then
I can find him.
And when I do, he'll wish he was thrown off that mountain.
I don't care what you think. I'll find Mirini. Do the right thing. Come with me.
What?
We could find her. Together. You could help me.
Oh, you think friendship is the answer? Running around like lost children looking for dear mother. You're so weak.
It's responsibility, not weakness. I won't abandon the whole family just for spite.
Responsibility? Get off your high horse. The cult has a plan, and it won't be interrupted by the likes of you.
Now who's on the high horse?
The cult let Mirini live. They let Nikolaos live. Why kill them now?
Because you live. You brought this on her and yourself. The cult is powerful, but they're mortals. I have the blood of gods, so they think you do too. But they'll see how wrong they are.
Taking your own mother isn't enough for them?
We're not abductors. We're political. Those who don't stand with us stand against us, and they pay for that mistake.
Like me.
Like you. I heard you're planning a trip to Athens. When you go, tell Pericles and his elitist scum they're next.
I'm going after the cult, you know.
You've seen our numbers. You've seen what I can do. And you still think you stand a chance?
Try me.
So having guts runs in the family, does it? You claim we have the same blood. So let's see what you can do.
We still found each other, brother.
I told you not to touch me.
How can he slap?
I won't believe this. I have to tell him what happened.
All right, I'll let you have that one, little brother. Consider it on the house. Next time you raise your hand, I'm cutting it off. Simple as that. Brother or no brother.
Well, was the legend true? Was it magnificent? What happened to you and your spear?
Slow down, Herodotus. My spear's stronger now. I can feel it. You were right. There was some kind of artifact there. It showed me a vision of me and my mother.
So, the ancient civilization is real. Kassandra, you have no idea the power you possess. All harnessed in Leonidas' spear.
That's not everything. Deimos followed me here. The cult's already moving, he told me himself. They're going after us. My family, Pericles.
Why would he tell you? Unless it was a trap.
It doesn't matter. We have to get to Athens to warn Pericles. And we need to find my mother before they do.
Then, we go to the Pniques. If Pericles is anywhere, he's there.
Alright.
Let's set sail!
Helm's ready for you, Commander.
Sounds like a plan. Athens, here we come.
Yeah.
That's them, Commander! They are heading this way!
Get ready! Archers! Get ready!
Watch those fire!
Well, well, well. Who do we have here? Pinks in Athens. Here we come.
The Spartans may draw near to our walls, but we must come together now for the glory of Athens.
Glory for you!
Friends, please! Just because the Spartans are near our walls does not mean we can act like them. A good crop. Shame the Spartans burned the fields where it grew. The Parthenon is glorious, Pericles, but at what cost? How many triremes could we have built instead?
We must not become divided.
We are divided, and the Spartans are winning. Act, Pericles, or I will.
Things Hello. Are worse than I feared. Cleon has turned the mob. We have to hurry.
Where?
To Pericles.
Okay. What are we exactly supposed to do about this?
Stay back.
She is no threat to Pericles. I assure you.
Ah, Herodotus. It's fine. Let them through.
It's good to see you again, Phokis.
And you as well. I only wish it were under better circumstances. And who's this?
Kassandra.
Welcome, Kassandra. And what did you think of your first taste of Athens?
Well,
I think you and Cleon both made good points.
Good points aren't at all what the crowd seem to care about. They're afraid. Cleon indulged their fear.
Pericles,
yeah.
We've come to...
We must choose our moment wisely and speak our words more privately.
Fine. We've come to you on urgent business.
As does everybody.
I may have told Kassandra you'd invite her to your symposium.
You'd ask me to exclude every Athenian and invite an outsider instead. You heard the crowd. They don't need another reason to hate me.
If she's working for you, maybe the prying eyes will see her as a servant.
I'm no one's servant.
Kassandra, this is Athens. If you want something, sometimes you have to play a role.
And what exactly is it that you want?
Well,
I'm looking for a woman who's very important to me. Herodotus said a symposium could be useful for gaining information.
He would be correct. I can get you in, although I can't promise the information you seek will be found.
Just tell me what to do.
First, check on my colleague, Medeiros. He was meant to meet me today, and it's not like him to miss an appointment.
Done.
Okay.
My friend, Phidias, needs to be taken out of Athens as soon as possible.
Anything else?
Yes. There's an ostracism vote taking place that could use your influence.
Right.
Ostracism?
Exile is a term you may be more familiar with. Here in Athens, we vote between two people to decide who should leave.
It's between the sophist, Anaxagoras, and another man, on trial for impiety. My contact near the Agora will give you the details.
Right.
Metiochos, you said he was your colleague?
A politician and ally. He's one of my most loyal friends.
Right.
Phidias? The famous sculptor? What did he do, exactly?
He stands accused of multiple offenses and is awaiting trial. You'll find him under close guard at his workshop.
Well, alright then. I better get to it.
I'll do it.
I'll expect you to use discretion.
Of course.
That went well. It isn't exactly an invitation, but the promise of one is just as good. Although I'm sure you still ask Aspasia if it's okay.
So long as it comes.
Alright. Excellent. It's like we'll have to do a lot of work for the symposium. Excuse me. Wait, aren't you that guy that was just ranting?
I saw you talking to my associate, Pericles.
From what I saw, you weren't
what of it?
Much associated.
That's just politics. Pericles is a good man, a fine man, just not the right man.
That's not what I heard.
From whose lips? His?
He was elected. Athens is the seat of democracy.
Oh, it is. It's just that the wrong man is sitting in that seat.
Did you actually need something, or did you just want
to... It's not how democracy works.
Pericles is holding parties for the rich and powerful while we're under siege. What I want is for my people to reclaim control. You could help me.
My services don't come cheap.
I understand the wills of commerce and the needs of the people. I will pay you handsomely for your services.
Alright, what exactly do you need?
And how do you want me to help?
Help Athens? Not me. The Spartans howl outside our city walls. Create chaos among their ranks. Make them suffer as we do. Think about it. Will you take my commission and show the Spartans we are not defeated yet?
I might.
I have no problem killing Spartans.
Good. Kill their commander, Nabis. Destroy their supplies and return to me with proof of your exploits. Show them that we have teeth too.
I'll get it done.
Right.
Trust me, this is a huge opportunity for you.
Yeah. If you say so, friend.
Here.
I might have a job for you. If you're as good a fighter as I've heard.
You've heard of me?
Don't let it go to your head. I hear about everything that happens in this city, Mystios.
With flattery like
well,
that,
good for you.
How can I possibly turn you down?
I'm not trying to flatter you. I'm trying to hire you. I need some Spartan military targets removed.
Hmm.
I'll help you if I can. Depending on what it is you need, General...
Demosthenes.
Very good.
My spies tell me the Spartans are mobilizing. What I want you to do is hamstring them. Get into their forts and remove the commanders in charge.
I guess that makes sense.
I'm thrilled you approve. You'll need to bring me the seals of the commanders you kill as proof. You'll be amply rewarded.
Those don't seem like standard Athenian tactics.
They're not. But it will work, and that's what matters. We've already lost too many Athenians to those savages using traditional warfare. The other generals disagree. But I refuse to let them destroy our chances.
What do they want to do?
They want honorable face-to-face warfare, pitting our forces directly against the Spartans. We're not going to win a contest of strength against those brutes. We need to outthink them. So, will you kill the commanders?
Maybe.
All right. I'll take the job.
Good. I might not have approval to deploy our men to do this, but I'm not about to let that stop me.
So,
what's your strategy?
Whatever it takes to protect Athenian lives and kill Spartans.
That's not what I meant. What's your personal strategy?
My career is none of your business. Know that I don't seek much. Only proper recognition of my strategic brilliance.
Uh-huh.
Where can I find them?
The Spartans have been making inroads into Athenian territory, taking over forts that once belonged to us. Make them pay for every inch.
What's so special about these seals?
Only elite Spartan commanders carry these seals. Those in charge of entire forts. They'd all die before parting with them. So bring me the seals as proof that they're dead.
All right.
You've told me enough. I'll get your seals for you, General.
Until then.
Don't it feel
Excuse me? What did I do? I just got it here. Oh. Come on now, guys. Let's not do this. Come on. There we go. Tried to warn you. You alright, there?
What was that all about?
The military suspects me of smuggling deserters from the war front. Okay, fine. They knew I was doing it.
Malaga's guards! They hit like bricks! Did you see a man on your way here? A skinny sort of idiot, wearing army colors.
No.
No, I didn't see anyone on my way here.
Not really.
Here by now. He must have run in the opposite direction, worrying that the guards would search Kidonia. That idiot. I told him to just listen to me.
You must be close to him to risk your life to help. Or he was paying you a lot.
I did it for the girl.
Girl? What girl? His wife? There's always a girl, isn't there?
Look, he got drafted into the war. She wouldn't stop crying. And my specialty is making people disappear. In a different way than you do. So, I decided to help them get back together.
Did you now?
You just want her for yourself.
That's not it. I mean, I have thought about it, but look, I just want to see her smile. All right?
I'm sure you do.
We need to get to Isabel. I mean, the wife. If the guards come after me, she'll be in danger too. Please go to her. I'll catch up when I can take her to safety.
I'll make sure she's safe. Where will I find her?
Follow the road to Kidonia. Her house will be on the left. Look for the green cloth on the doorpost. Quickly. I'll catch up as soon as I can.
Kiere.
All right, pal. I'll see what I can do.
I saw the guards dead outside. Good job, Mysterios.
What guards?
They got to her before me. There was nothing I could do but avenge her.
She trusted me, Mysterios. All I wanted was to make her smile. But every time I tried, all I brought her was pain. It's all I ever do. I shouldn't have told her about my stupid plan to reunite her with her husband. I did this to her. Didn't I?
Nah.
You didn't. Nobody wanted things to end like this. Least of all you.
Everything seemed okay when she smiled, you know? I didn't care who she was smiling at.
You did your best.
No one's best is ever enough.
No. No, it's not.
No, I suppose not.
I was going to give it to her when I helped them escape Kidonia. To get them through tough times. They won't need it anymore, and it's too heavy for me to bear. Take it as payment for your troubles. And leave me, please.
All right. See you around, friend.
Lynx don't prowl for nothing. Must be something in that cave.
Lynx? Are there lynx nearby? That's not a lynx, that's a man. It's a civilian. Sir? Where are you? Don't worry, I'm here to help, friend.
I can hear you. Please.
Oh. There you are.
I knew you weren't the lynx. Heard your footsteps. Only two. Lynx have four.
You're serious?
That's right, very good.
These lynx, they're a bit tougher than the sea bass I usually catch. Could you help a fellow hunter home to his wife?
Sure.
Thank the gods. She's in Scandia Harbor.
Okay.
Tell me about your wife.
She's the real lynx.
Huh?
Please don't tell her I said that.
Of course.
You've lost a lot of blood. If you're going to make it home, we'll need to move now.
Please, get me back to my wife in Scandia Harbor.
Alright, alright.
Ow! Ow!
Up we go, friend. Here we go. Let's get you home. Excuse me. You must be the wife. Here is your husband.
And you must be his wife.
The wife of an idiot, I'm afraid.
Right.
Mr. Idiot?
My love, you're alive!
So, are we having lynx for dinner?
Enough about the lynx.
Oh.
You're the strangest people I've ever met.
Love is strange, Mistios. Best to embrace it.
Wonderful.
Right,
I'll
well...
To, here.
Yeah. Good luck with that. Alright, well, I think right now we have enough fragments to upgrade our spear. Maybe even upgrade it twice. We'll see. Here we go. Plonk.
Forge activated. Synchronizing retransmission chronosity. Contact engaged.
Huh. Neat. And here we go again. Let's get another upgrade while we're here.
Forge activated. Synchronizing retransmission chronosity. Contact engaged.
Excellent. All right. Now, we are... Where's the exit again? Over here. Now, we're ready to get back out there and, get back into it, you know what I'm saying? the fuck down. Dirty pig. Get out of here. Hey! Hey! Get out of here. Your mama's dead. Get the hell out of here. Scram. Go get a job or something. Fucking losers. Got nothing better to do than to spam your bullshit attacks? Get this cheap-ass shit out of here. Never seen something more rigged in my life. More rigged than a fucking carnival. Oh no, I've lost 25% of my health. Let me just spawn 5 pigs from out of nowhere. Sure. The player won't even notice. He won't even care. What's game design again?
Way ahead is not safe. What's the problem?
A creature beyond the understanding of mortals claims these grounds. You have been warned. I hope you have a coin for the ferryman.
Thanks for the warning, sister. Appreciate it. I don't know what I would do without you. Alright, well, took me a little bit, but I'm back with the Caledonian boar's pelt. So.
Did you get lost? Here, I killed your pig.
No. I just had better things to do.
Of that there is no doubt.
Yeah.
You shouldn't doubt my abilities. Lesson learned. But I'm also interested in seeing what else you can do.
Oh?
Go on.
And what did you have in mind?
Many things. But first, to business. There are beasts that roam this world, but are not fully of it. They've been placed here by the gods as trials, as tests.
These beasts are creatures like any other. The world is full of mysteries, but not everything unexplained is ordained by the gods.
Perhaps before this is over, you will have a different opinion.
What exactly do you want me to do?
I want you to prove your worth in the eyes of Artemis, and hunt these creatures.
I don't need to prove my worth to anyone. Just tell me what's the reward.
With each pelt you return, I will grant you a boon from Artemis. If you are able to slay all the beasts, well, let's say your relationship with the Daughters of Artemis will be forever changed.
Alright. Fair enough.
Alright. I'll do it. Now, just how many of these animals are there?
Artemis has laid out 8 trials, and you have already started the journey. Hunt down those that remain.
How will I recognize the creatures?
Oh, you'll know.
I think I may already have some of them.
Bring the pelts to me. I'll await your return with my sisters, the Daughters of Artemis. I hope you don't make me wait too long to see your face again.
Beast Slayer, I'm glad to see you, Hafnir.
Hello.
I didn't think you would be. The path I set you on is fraught with danger. You could have been killed or given up.
Sure.
There's nothing I've faced that I haven't overcome.
Be careful. Pride is a shield of reeds. It can blind you from danger and offers no protection.
Uh-huh. Alright, so if you say 8, and I've only taken down 4 technically, that means I've got 4 more beasts to hunt, so... You know what? I'll return.
I'll return when I have more pelts.
Yeah, well, we'll catch up later.
Is it a big hurt or a little hurt?
I don't know.
Well, does it hurt like a bear biting you? Or a mouse?
Like 3 mouses. No, like 4.
So a puppy bite-sized hurt. Got it.
Will the hurt go away?
Tell you what. You have to scare it away. If you roar like a lion, it'll run.
Grr!
Good job. Now run along home.
You must be a physician.
Yes, I'm Lycaon.
You must be a Mystios. Are you here for treatment?
Not quite.
That depends. Will I have to roar for you too?
Sometimes the best medicine I can give my patients is a dose of hope. I take it you're not in need of care.
I'm healthy as a horse.
No, Mara.
I'm strong and prepared for anything. My patients need mandrake herbs. There's a patch of them growing by a little stream southeast of here.
Are you too busy to pick them?
Too chewy. A pack of wolves is resting near the stream. I'll pay you generously for your trouble.
You know how to talk to Mystios. Is that all you want? The mandrake herbs?
For now. Bring them back to me, and I'll package them for my patients. Then we'll see.
Alright.
I'll bring you the herbs. You said they were southeast of here.
Yes. By a little stream northeast of Kira. The flowers haven't bloomed yet, but the leaves are a distinctive gray-green. Thank you.
Sure. Until then. Fucking hell. Alright. That was quite the escalation. I thought I had everything under control there, but apparently not. Those explosive arrows were like, were as efficient as firecrackers. I really thought those were gonna be the key there, but yeah. Oh well. Well, at least we cleared out the area, made it a bit safer. So, it's good. We're not gonna get paid for it, but
these must be the herbs Lycaon wanted.
We need three. Always good to have three. Karos? No? No. Doesn't know what gray-green means. He's a bit colorblind. It's alright. Oh! There we go. Oh, five! I see. Right. So just follow the stream.
Alright. Time to go back to the physician.
Excellent.
Here, I found your herbs.
Thank you. I'll prepare these for my patients. Could you please stay a while?
I'll wait.
Sure.
I've crushed the herbs so they'll be easier to take. Could you please bring them to my patients? Just tell them they're for me, Lycaon.
I thought I brought you more herbs than this.
I needed to save a double dose for my grandmother. I'll give it to her soon.
Sure. I'll just deliver the rest then.
Thank you. All my patients are in and around the Hora of Delphi. One should be at the animal pens to the west. One is building a house in the northeastern corner. And one works in the fields to the south. Come back here when you're done.
I'm sure I can find them.
Yeah. Just to be clear, you are going to be paying me extra for this, right? Because I don't run around looking for patients for free. Time is money, after all.
Legaon sends his regards.
The medicine he promised. Thank you. Tell me, did he look well?
He didn't look sick to
me.
I've seen him up and walking around at all hours, mumbling to himself. He seems worried. I should bring him some sweets to cheer him up.
I'm sure he'd appreciate that.
Who doesn't like sweets? You, just focus on, you know, getting better and all that. And then you can worry about our healer friend later.
Legaon made this medicine for you.
Thanks. See, I take care of these beasts, and Legaon takes care of me. Too bad nobody takes care of him, though.
What do you mean?
His parents died young. His grandmother raised him, but then she was born under a cursed star. Never mind that.
Oh.
He's a good boy.
I'm sure he is.
Okay, if you say so. I don't know why you felt the need to share that information with a complete stranger, but sure. Hello.
These herbs are from Legaon.
Oh, thank you! That physician is so thoughtful and so handsome. It's too bad he's decided not to marry.
Why not?
He just told me some nonsense about not wanting to burden an innocent woman with his worries. Personally, I just wish he'd been honest and said I'm not his type.
I wonder why he'd say that.
Hmm. That's a bit odd. What's going on with this Legaon fella? First he doesn't go and pick his own herbs, then he doesn't distribute his own medicine. And now, all of this. Strange.
I delivered all your medicine. Seems you have a lot of people concerned for your well-being.
Thanks. My grandmother, Praxithea, I have to bring her the last of the medicine. Will you come along with me to her house? I think I need your help.
You haven't gone there yet? What have you been doing this whole time?
Yes. I don't know what's going on here.
Sure.
Oh, thank you. Please, my grandmother's house is this way.
Okay, you want me to hold your hand?
Would you say you've killed many people?
Why do you ask me that?
If someone is impious to the point of doing grave injustice to people as well as the gods, do they not deserve punishment?
What did Praxithea do?
She spoke false prophecies for years. Those who came to her for advice received only lies.
Your grandmother was an oracle?
Yes, up on the hill in Delphi. She confessed to me recently that she never heard the gods, and only repeated the words she was told.
Told by vile people with evil intentions.
Exactly. Wars have been fought over those words. She can't be left unpunished.
My family was torn apart by a false prophecy. If it was one of hers, I may take matters into my own hands.
Stand aside, all of
you. Yeah. Where is your old crone, anyways? Hiding in an old hut somewhere, in the middle of the forest, brewing her cauldron. Oh, that's not her, is it?
Get out of here, Legaon! I know what you want to do.
Oh.
You'll just bring more shame on our family.
I don't want to do this, Agavi. But for the sake of justice, we can't let Praxithea live.
It's out of our hands anyway. Some strange men were searching the village today, looking for her. I brought them here, and they dragged her away.
What kind of justice is that?
Oh.
You won't understand. She was an impious old fool. Now we have nothing more to worry about. Who are you anyway?
I'm Kassandra. I've also been wronged by a false prophecy. It might have been your grandmother's.
If we don't find her, we can't settle any of this. Please help me figure out where she's been taken.
I'll look for clues.
Yeah, all right.
What did you expect me to do? All that talk about killing? A solution showed up?
Will you quit your nagging? Give me a headache here.
No ordinary thief would have left something so valuable behind.
Okay. More clues outside.
This looks like a contract. Deliver the package to the drop-off and don't damage it. If they mean LeCount's grandmother, chances are she's alive.
The package. Okay. So, where exactly could they have taken the package?
I'm surprised Apollo himself didn't strike her down long ago.
Uh-huh. Why are these clues so hard to find? What happened to the gold little triangle things?
Have you seen anything strange going on around here?
Well, if bandits taking over my cousin's farm is strange, yes.
What did they do?
Gave her a running start. She can't go back there. They've set up camp, and they're armed and dangerous.
Interesting.
I see.
Where is that farm?
It's not far west of here, but I wouldn't mess with those bandits.
Thanks for the advice.
Yeah. I'm sure you wouldn't.
Praxithea was kidnapped and brought to a farm west of here. The bandits were hired to deliver her alive.
Thank you for figuring that out, Kassandra.
I'm no fool, Lycaon. Your sister put Praxithea in great danger, and you've been asking me about killing. Do you want me to end her life?
No. It has to be me. I need to kill her.
She's your grandmother, and you're no killer. You should give this more thought.
She's my responsibility. I don't want her to suffer. That's why I asked you for Mandrake. It's a painkiller. But for now, will you go to the farm to stop those bandits? I don't think I can take them all on myself.
Yeah, all right.
Let's go find Praxithea.
Thanks, Kassandra. You said the farm was to the west. I'll meet you there.
All right. See you there, friend. Is this the west? East? Southwest. That way. All right. Here we go.
I should try to stay out of sight.
Hey, guys. How are we doing today? Alright. Good to see y'all. Hello. You must be Praxithea. Where are you going? Okay. No set of movements, though. Alright. You're pretty spry for an old crone. If you don't mind me saying so. Alright?
Thank you for saving me, dear child.
Don't thank me, voice of Apollo. Or were those someone else's words you spoke?
So you've met my grandson. You're right. I lied to everyone. I am so sorry. The gods should have killed me by now. Instead, they made me live with my remorse.
Why did you spread lies? People trusted you. You were supposed to bring them the word of Apollo.
I didn't plan to. Not when I was chosen to be the oracle of Apollo. But I met people there who told me I must speak the words they asked, or else my family would suffer for my disobedience.
Family? Do you remember telling a Spartan family that their younger child must die? A grieving mother, with eyes like mine.
I am so sorry for what you have lost.
Who wanted you kidnapped? These brutes didn't come up with the idea themselves.
Please, don't ask me that. The ones who want to punish me now, the ones who told me what to say, they would bury you alive if I told you about them.
The ones with masks and dark cloaks. The cult of Cosmos.
Do not speak their name.
Oh?
Did she tell you? Is she the oracle who brought ruin on your family?
I'm sorry for what I've done. I accept my punishment. But please, don't let my grandson kill me. Lycaon's a good man, a healer. This would break him.
No, this is my responsibility. I must be the one to end her.
So, remind me again, why are we killing her?
I've killed enough people to know that violence has no end. Better to move on, and make the best of the lives the gods have given you.
Move on? But you said Praxithea ruined your family.
She can do no more harm. Killing her for revenge won't change what happened. Besides, didn't you tell me something about hope?
Thank you for your mercy. I promise I will do good with what's left of my days.
So, yeah.
Right, Kassandra. I might not be able to forgive my grandmother, not right away. But she can go on with her life, and I with mine.
I think you've made the right decision, Lycaon.
Wonderful.
How do you do this? Decide who lives and who dies.
How do you do it, Lycaon? All those lives depending on you, needing your healing and kindness.
I think I need you, Kassandra. Not to kill anybody or find anything. Just to stay with me.
Eh, what the hell?
I can't stay forever, but for now, let me take care of you, healer.
Whew. All right. That was exhilarating.